It is one of the deadliest cancers out there, only a 5% survival rate.
Pancreatic cancer is back in the news after civil rights icon Representative John Lewis revealed he is battling an advanced stage of the disease. In tonight's Health Beat, Reed Binion explains what makes this cancer so lethal.
Pancreatic cancer. It's the third deadliest cancer in the U.S. after lung and colorectal cancers. But doctors are still left somewhat stumped by the disease. One of the biggest concerns when it comes to pancreatic cancer is that patients often don't exhibit any symptoms during the early treatable stages of the tumor, which is what makes it so deadly. In fact, about 95% of people who get pancreatic cancer will die from it. The disease tends to strike those older than 45, the average age being 71, and men have a slightly higher likelihood of developing the disease. Of the two types of tumors that develop in the pancreas, exocrine and endocrine, exocrine tumors tend to be more aggressive. This cancer can be controlled by surgery if it is found before it is spread. Other options, such as transplants or approved medication, are making progress, but can come with some serious side effects. The oblong organ deep in your abdomen plays a big role in your digestive and endocrine systems.
And according to the Mayo Clinic, factors that may increase your risk of pancreatic cancer include smoking, diabetes, obesity, and a family history of the cancer.